Flutter is a fantastic tool for building cross-platform applications quickly and effectively, as it allows you to launch your app for Android, iOS, Windows, macOS, and Linux, all from a single code base. However, one of the most common criticisms of Flutter throughout its history has been its performance, especially on certain platforms like Apple's devices. That's why it's crucial for you as a developer to have the right skills to optimize your app as much as possible, ensuring it runs fast and smoothly on the user's device. Ideally, the user shouldn't be able to tell the difference between a native app and one built with Flutter. I've been working with Flutter since the framework was still in its beta phase, and over the years, I've picked up quite a few tricks that helped me achieve this goal. In this video, I want to share with you the 5 most important aspects I believe you should keep in mind when it comes to optimizing your Flutter application. So, without further ado, let's dive in. The first piece of advice I can give you is to avoid creating methods that return widgets. One of the most common mistakes I see among Flutter developers, especially those who came from other frameworks or are just getting started, is creating methods that return widgets. While this might seem like a harmless shortcut to keep your code organized, it actually has a direct negative impact on your app's performance. The reason is simple. Every time Flutter's build method runs and hits that method, it will create a brand new widget instance. Even if nothing has changed, Flutter has no way of knowing that the widget is the same, because you're giving it a freshly created object every single time. As a result, you lose Flutter's ability to optimize the widget tree and avoid unnecessary rebuilds. Let's take a look at an example of this problem. At first glance, this code looks clean and functional. However, every time Flutter rebuilds example widget, it will call buildListItem method for every single item in the list, generating new widget instances even if the list hasn't changed at all. If your app refreshes this layout 60 times per second, you might think that Flutter will need to build 100 widgets for each refresh, that is, a total of 6,000 builds. However, Flutter applies plenty of optimizations under the hood. In this example, each list item ends up being built around 300 times. The proper solution is to extract the widget into a dedicated class. Instead of building the list items through a method, it's better to define a separate widget class for each item. This allows Flutter to compare widget instances properly and optimize rebuilds. Let's refactor this example. Now, Flutter can treat each list item as an independent widget. If the parent rebuilds, Flutter won't recreate every list item unnecessarily, it will only update what's needed. If we go back to how many times Flutter builds each widget in the list, previously, Flutter was building each one around 300 times. Now, thanks to this small change, Flutter only needs to build the item in the list about 57 times. It's also worth noting that other optimizations are happening under the hood here, especially with the ListView widget. So, as a rule of thumb, you should almost never create widgets inside methods. Instead, extract them into their own classes, even private ones within the same file, to help Flutter do its job efficiently. Your widget tree will be cleaner, your app will perform better, and you will make life easier for both yourself and the framework. Let's move on to the second tip that will definitely help you optimize your Flutter app even further. But before that, if you're serious about improving your apps, you need to know how to use good algorithms. And what better way to do that than with a platform full of top quality educational content taught by some of the best educators and researchers? I'm talking about today's sponsor, Brilliant. Brilliant is an interactive learning platform that helps you learn a little bit every day, with thousands of hands-on lessons on topics like math, science, AI, and of course, programming. Now, in the case of app optimization, you could easily spend hours hunting down scattered, boring tutorials all over the internet. But Brilliant offers something much better, a cohesive and interactive learning experience that actually helps you build your skills in a structured way. In fact, interactive learning has been proven to be up to 6 times more effective than just watching traditional tutorials. With Brilliant, you can set goals that fit your schedule. Even just 5 minutes a day is enough to start making progress, or you can go deeper if you have more time. Brilliant brings everything together in one place and adapts to you, your pace, and your energy. If you'd like to try Brilliant for free for 30 days, head over to brilliant.org/David Serrano or scan the QR code you see on the screen. Plus, by using that link, you will also get 20% off your annual subscription. Just click the link and give it a try. It won't cost you a thing for those first 30 days. Thanks to Brilliant for sponsoring this video. Let's continue with the second tip, which is to prefer ListView.builder for lists instead of passing an array of widgets, especially for lists with many elements. When rendering lists in Flutter, a common approach is to pass an array of widgets directly to the children parameter of ListView. While this works fine for small lists, it quickly becomes a problem as your list grows. That's because Flutter will instantiate all those widgets in memory immediately, even if most of them are invisible. This increases memory usage and slows down your initial build. It's true that Flutter won't call the build method for every widget right away. It only builds what's visible plus a small buffer for smooth scrolling. However, since all widgets instances already exist in memory, you're still paying the cost upfront. Let's take a look at an example of this problem. In this example, we're generating 10,000 items and passing them directly to ListView. Flutter will try to instance all 10,000 widgets immediately, even though the user will only see a small handful of them at any given time. This is a recipe for performance issues, especially on lower-end devices. To avoid this problem, simply use the builder constructor. Flutter will only create the widgets as they're needed, keeping memory usage low and scroll performance smooth. Here's how you can refactor this example. Now, instead of instantiating 10,000 widgets upfront, Flutter will only instantiate the ones that are currently visible. This simple change massively improves performance, especially with large lists. So, as a rule of thumb, whenever you work with lists of dynamic or large datasets, you should always prefer ListView.builder over passing an explicit list of widgets. It's a small change that has a big impact, keeping your app fast and responsive, even as your data grows. Let's now move on to the third tip, which is to avoid heavy logic and repetitive calculations within the build method. One of the best ways to keep your Flutter app fast and responsive is to keep the build method as light as possible. Remember, build can be called many times during the lifecycle of your widget. If you place heavy operations inside build, you're forcing Flutter to repeat that work over and over again. But it doesn't stop there. Even lightweight operations can become problematic if you repeat them unnecessarily inside the same build method. Flutter executes everything inside build, line by line, so if you call the same calculation multiple times, it will recompute it every single time. Let's look at an example of this problem. In this example, findMax is called twice in the same build, causing the calculation to run 2 times unnecessarily. Numbers.contains is an expensive operation for large lists. Every time the widget rebuilds, these calculations will happen again. The solution is simple: compute your values once, store them in local variables, and reuse them throughout build. Here's the improved version. Now, even if build is called multiple times, each expensive operation only runs once per build. This keeps your UI fast and avoids redundant work. But we can do it even better. We can move the calculations to init state. With this approach, the heavy calculations happen only once during the widget's lifecycle. Even if the widget reveals multiple times, for example, because of unrelated UI updates, the values are already stored and reused, keeping your build method clean and extremely fast. So, as a rule of thumb, avoid placing heavy logic inside build, and always compute your values once per build, or even better, once per widget lifecycle, if possible. Next, I will explain the fourth tip for today, which is the use of isolates for intensive calculations. Flutter runs your app's code in a single thread called the main isolate. This thread handles both your app's logic and its UI rendering. If you perform heavy computations on the main isolate, such as image processing, large data parsing, or complex mathematical calculations, you risk blocking the UI thread, leading to janky animations, delayed interactions, or even complete freezes. To avoid this, you can offload heavy tasks to a separate isolate. Flutter provides this mechanism specifically to help you run CPU-intensive work in parallel without impacting the smoothness of your app. Imagine you're applying a filter to an image inside your build or right after loading it on the main thread. In this example, apply heavy filter simulates a heavy synchronous operation running on the main isolate. During this time, the app's UI is blocked and the user cannot interact with it. The proper solution is to use an isolate. Let's improve this by moving the heavy operation to a separate isolate. This way, the UI remains smooth while the processing happens in the background. We promote that function to a top-level function. By using the compute function, you offload the heavy task to a background isolate. Your main UI thread stays free to handle animations and user interactions. When your app needs to handle heavy operations like image processing, data parsing, or complex calculations, offload that work to an isolate. It keeps your app responsive and smooth, providing a much better user experience. And to finish this video, let's talk about the fifth tip, which is about optimizing the use of images. Images are often one of the biggest factors affecting your app's performance. Poorly optimized images can lead to long loading times, high memory usage, and even frame drops if they're not handled carefully. There are three main things to consider when using images in your Flutter app. Number one, use multiple resolutions of your images. Flutter supports up to three image variants. This allows you to provide lower resolution images for low density screens and higher resolution images for high density screens. Flutter automatically selects the correct image based on the device pixel density. If you don't provide these variants, Flutter will scale your image, but it might load unnecessarily large images on devices that don't need them, wasting memory and processing power. The correct approach is to provide proper resolution variants following Flutter's conventions. Flutter will automatically pick the right image based on the device's screen density, giving you better performance without sacrificing image quality. Number two, use the right image format. Different formats serve different needs. PNG for images requiring transparency or sharp edges, like icons. JPEG for photos and complex images with lots of colors. WebP for modern, highly compressed images that support both transparency and photos. Choosing the right format ensures a good balance between quality and file size. And number three, compress and size your image properly. No matter the format, always compress your images and use the correct resolution. Avoid using images straight from design tools or cameras at full resolution. For example, if your design only displays an image at 300 by 300 pixels, there is no need to load a 3000 by 3000 pixel asset. Oversized images consume unnecessary memory and slow down your app. Images are a critical part of your app's performance. By providing proper resolution variants, choosing the right formats, and compressing your assets, you will reduce your app's memory usage and improve loading times, all while keeping your UI crisp and fast on every device. And that wraps up my list of the 5 most important tips that help you optimize your Flutter application. If you found this video helpful, leaving a like and a comment about which tip you found most interesting really helps the channel grow. These interactions tell YouTube that the video is valuable, so it gets shown to more people who might find it useful as well. And of course, if you want to keep learning about Flutter, stay up to date with new releases, and discover new technologies, don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Thank you so much for watching all the way to the end. I hope you have a beautiful rest of your day. Goodbye.